Hello and welcome to Craft with Sarah. This is part one of a two-part video tutorial on how you can cut one image out of another in Design Space and then turn it into a layered design. So this video was actually a request from somebody in my Facebook group. They asked how you could put the shape of the American flag with all the different colors inside the outline of another shape. And the example they gave was a shark. And I thought that was such a wonderfully random image combination that I just had to do it. So this is going to be part one of the video, which shows how to turn these two images into one and then turn it into a layered cardstock design. So with a layered cardstock design, because we're cutting out of card and sticking it together with 3D foam pads, we need every layer to be complete, we need it to be full, and our aim is to have as many layers as possible. Part two of this video, which will actually be a separate video that I will upload on my YouTube, is going to be how you do the same image combination, but that time it will be for how to do it from vinyl. Let's get started on our layered cardstock design. First, let's choose our shapes. So I'm going to go into images, and you can see I've already searched for American flag here. And I'm going to choose this one because it's all straight. So rather than the ones that are kind of flying in the wind, I think a straight one's going to be easier. And then I also need a shark. I'm going to choose this second one at the top and then press insert images. So here are my two images. I've got the American flag, which is made up of three layers, one for each of the colors. And then I've got the shark. So to add the flag inside the shark so that I can turn it into a layered cardstock image, I'm going to need an outline of the shark. Luckily, the offset feature in Design Space makes this really easy to do. So click offset, and I'm going to go 0.1 as my offset, which is quite a small, thin size. In fact, I'm going to make my shark bigger first so that their outline doesn't look quite as big. There we go. Press apply, and now we've got an offset. So you can see we've got the bigger layer and then the smaller one. We need to cut these out from each other so that we've just got the outline. So drag a box around those two layers and then press slice down the bottom of the layers panel. This is what we've ended up with. And we don't need the solid shark, so I'm going to delete those. And I've just got this one instead. So what we're also going to need is a solid version of this shark, which is the full size of the outline. So that's why we had to delete the other two filled in ones, because they were just the size of the bit in the middle. We want one that's the bit all the way to the edge, because that's what we're going to cut out of the flag. So let's right click the shark and duplicate, and then on this one, go into contour and press hide all contours, and that's going to give us a solid color. We want one of these for each of the colours of the flag. So I'll make this one white. Oh, and there's a little bug in Design Space where you can't see the outline. So I'll actually make it grey so we can still see it. Right click and duplicate. And I'm going to want a red one and a blue one. I'm also going to need duplicates of the outline, and you'll see why in a minute. So I'm going to start with a black one, and this is going to be my top layer just around the edge to give it a bit more definition. So then I want to duplicate it and color it for each of the colors that are going to be in my flag. And again, I'll make that one gray instead of white just so we can still see it. I now want to select all the shark layers by pressing one in the layers panel, press shift or control on the keyboard, and click all of those sharks, the outlines and the filled in ones. Go to align, center, and now they're all one on top of the other. So now we can press group, and then I'm going to go down them and hide every single one by clicking the eye icon, apart from my black outline. Now these are grouped, it means I'm moving them all together. Even though you can't see the other ones, they're moving along as I move this shark. So I'm going to use this to work out where I want the flag to go inside. If at this point your shark is appearing underneath the flag, go into arrange and then press center front. Mine's grayed out because my shark's already at the front of the flag. So I think probably about there will look right. And then I'll just fill in this extra space in the nose with some more blue once we've cut it out. Okay, so now we can think about how we're going to cut this out. So press all the sharks again and press ungroup. This time I want to hide that outline of the black shark and bring in the colour that's on the bottom of the flag. So mine is my grey solid. I'm actually jumping into this video now with a quick re-record of how to do the bottom layer of the shark. So when I originally recorded this video, which is all the footage you've been watching so far, I went through all the steps of slicing the white part of the shark out of the white part of the flag. And then once I'd finished, I was like, why did I bother doing that? Because the whole of my bottom layer is going to be solid white. And I've already got that on the shark you can see on the screen. So at this point, because for layered cardstock designs, you want your bottom layer to all be completely solid with no cuts taken out of it, you don't actually have to do anything clever or fancy. So what we want to do instead is select the bottom layer of the American flag, so the white rectangle that I'm showing with the arrow now, and delete that. We don't need that because we've already got our white shark that you can see on the screen. Okay, it's kind of grey, but that's because when I made it white, you couldn't see the outline. We also want to delete the part of the shark layer that's just the outline. Again, I'll show it with the arrow now. And again, that's because we don't need it. We've already got the solid shark. So this is my little re-record just to say I kind of made it a bit more complicated in the beginning when I first recorded it, but I'm just editing it now to let you know that it doesn't have to be that complicated. So your layers panel going forward will look a little bit different to mine just because I'm now going to jump back into my original recording where I did all those fancy steps I didn't need to. So just don't worry if your layers look a little bit different to how mine are going to look going forward. As long as you've got that solid white shark on your screen, you are all good to continue. So that's my bottom layer done. I can hide this one by pressing the I, and now it's time to move to the next layer, which is going to be my red one. So I need to turn on my solid red shark. So now I can click my solid red shark in the layers panel, press Control or Shift and choose the red American flag layer and press Slice. So this time I'm going to have a little look at what I've got. I don't need the two original shark layers, so I can delete those. I don't need this outline, so I can delete that. But this is looking really weird at the moment because all it's been able to cut out is that red in the middle. So this is why we turn on that red outline of the shark and then click that outline, Control or Shift and choose your sliced results part and then press Weld. And that would join them together into one layer. I'm going to just hide the blue flag layer and show you what we've got here. So we've got this tiny gap at the bottom of the fin where there was white on the original flag, and that's going to be really small for the Cricut to cut out, so I want to remove that. Also, we've got this rectangle on the shark's head, which I'm also going to fill in because it's going to have the stars over the top. So press your layer and go into contour, and then I'm going to take out those spaces and that tiny bit in the tail, the fin. And if I zoom in, where's it gone? There's also a tiny little gap at the top of the tail, which I will take out. Okay, so this is what it looks like now. So this is ready. I can hide this and then move on to the blue. So I've got the blue flag and the solid blue shark. And then I'm going to click on one of them, press Control or Shift and press the flag and press Slice. Delete the first two layers and then delete the one that's the outside of the flag. Turn on your blue shark outline and then select that one, and the blue star one and press weld. Again, we've got a tiny gap in that top star and also the nose, which I'm going to contour out. So just like I did before, take out any little gaps you've got. And there. So now if I turn these other layers on, you can see what we've got. So it's now got the American flag inside the shark outline, but it's not quite right at the moment because the stars should be white. To make them white, right click on the blue layer and press duplicate, or you can click it in the layers panel and press the duplicate button at the top. Or one other way to do it is to click it on your canvas, right click and duplicate. So there's three different ways to do that. I'm going to make this one white, or just off-white, so that I can still see it. And then select everything and go align center to put it all back on top of each other. I need to move this new white layer below the blue one. So with it clicked, I'm going to go into arrange, move backward. And that's going to move it down one layer, so now it's underneath the blue. To fill in those stars, press contour, and then I'm going to go hide all contours and then click the big area again to show it. So there we go, now that's filled in, and of course it is showing grey now, but it will be white when we cut it out. And then if you want to, you can turn on your last outline layer, which is the black one here. Oops, that didn't move because it was still hidden, so let's center it again. Click on the shark outline, the black one we've got left, and go arrange, center front. And now this is on the top, you can see it just gives a nice definition. And this would be my shark done. So it is, let's just have a look at all the layers. Got 1, 2, 3, 4, and then an optional one, 5. A 5-layer shark. If you didn't want to do the outline, you could get away with slicing this layer and this layer along the edge of the rectangle and just have that bit standing out more than the other layers and not have the rest of the shark. So that's a little alteration you could make if you wanted to. I'm going to put these all back on top of each other. So let's go select all, align, center. What I think I might do is just cut another couple of stars out of the blue because it looks a little bit strange with all of that blue in his nose. So let's choose a star, make it small. I'm going to zoom in so I can see a bit better. And then make this the same size. I'm going to make it yellow just so I can see it a bit better. And then just add a couple. Of course, this is optional and it does mean that we've now got the wrong amount of stars for the flag. So it's up to you if you want to keep it, you know, true to life, or if you want to make it a bit more conceptual so that it fits your design a little bit better. So that's, you know, a choice for you to make. Now I'm going to select all of those stars and weld them together by pressing weld. Then select that layer, press control on my keyboard and choose the blue layer and press slice. Delete the yellow ones and the stars all on their own. And now I've got those cut out. So once I've put my black layer back on top, you can see how that's going to look. And now it's not got that big space of empty blue in the nose. So now I can resize this ready to cut it. So press select all and group. And now you can resize it either by dragging and dropping the little arrow icon or type your width or height into the box. Let's go 7.5. If you wanted to turn this into a print then cut, so maybe you're making stickers with it, then just click and then press flatten down the bottom of the layers panel, and that will turn it into one layer, which is now a print then cut. I'm just going to undo that so I've still got all the different layers. So once everything's cut out, you can use 3D foam pads on the back of each layer and then stick them to the one underneath to create the finished design. I apologise for the lack of video here, I've been having some camera troubles, so I had to take pictures. For the top layer, I used glue because it was so thin, and here is the finished design. Don't forget, if you'd like to learn how to design it from vinyl instead of cardstock, then check out the link to the other video in the description of this one, because it is a slightly different technique. But here's what it looks like when you compare the vinyl and the cardstock design. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please give it a thumbs up, leave me a comment, and of course, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching. Bye.